Roseanne's racist tweet and the show's cancellation, we saw the most engagement we've ever seen for a story. As of this morning, it's garnered nearly 23 million posts and comments. A fair amount of those comments are actually trying to justify and explain away the initial tweet.
Yeah, so we want to examine that a little bit more. And for that, we go back to Layla and Gary, guys.
Hey, thanks, guys. So we spoke with a diversity expert who said Roseanne's tweet was not only racist, but Islamophobic.
Yeah, racist comparisons of people of color to apes and monkeys. That goes back more than a century in this country. If you didn't know, now you do. So we asked, why is it hard for people to recognize that the tweet is racist?
The problem is that we have a much deeper problem in this nation with someone being called racist, even if they are racist, than we have with racism and facing and acknowledging racism.
Dr. Jones DeWeaver also responded to President Trump's tweet where he didn't denounce Roseanne's comments, but instead, without offering specifics, asked why ABC hasn't apologized to him for horrible statements they made about him. She says, it is a false equivalency for Mr. Trump to draw any comparisons to any other non-racist insults. Our expert agrees this is a teachable moment about the importance of words and that words do matter. I've heard a lot of people say that this is a teachable moment for those who didn't know the history behind the comparison between people of color and monkeys and apes and the propaganda that was distributed, you know, back during slavery and even into, sadly, even into current times.
Of course.
There's been propaganda distributed with hateful speech and making that comparison. It was made about Michelle Obama and President Obama. This is not a political speech here, not political stance. This is a fact of the stuff that was out there. So do you talk about how someone's attacking your politics? You know, you can compare that to politics or how someone's attacking how you talk. That's a comparison. But saying something is political versus racist, that's two different things, I think.
No, of course. And you nailed it on the head yesterday when you were saying, I mean, this goes back not just to this tweet in particular or some stupid thing somebody might have said last year. I mean, this is decades and decades and really centuries of, you know, those that link, somebody saying something dumb like that, and obviously it being offensive. The question I ask, we all know what Roseanne tweeted was dumb, shouldn't do it. However, is it a slippery slope? We see this so often now. Somebody tweets something, and people get mad about it, in this case, deservedly so, but they lose jobs. I mean, these are severe repercussions. Obviously, Roseanne's fine financially. She's gonna be okay, but for the people who do lose their jobs over tweets and things like that, is that harsh?
I can't weigh in on that. It depends on the company's policy. Yep. So in this case, ABC thought it was just not going to fly on their watch. We don't know how that affected advertisers. We heard members of that show say, I'm not going to return. This is before she was fired, before the show was canceled. There were castmates saying, or like Wanda Sykes, somebody who's a writer or producer for the show, saying, I'm not going to return.
Sure.
So you have to make that decision. But can the show survive without her? I don't know.
I mean, it's the namesake of the show. So you'd obviously have to do a little bit of twisting, and obviously they have such deep-rooted characters on that show. It probably could, but the namesake of the show is no longer on the show, right?
Or someone else might pick it up.
Of course.
Let some time fly.
Yeah.
The dust settles a little bit, and she ends up on Netflix.
Yeah.
Never know.
Kathy Griffin did something like that. You know, she made a boneheaded move.
And
some time passed, and all of a sudden, here she is again.
Selling out shows, apparently.
Yeah.
Or trying to.
Mm-hmm.